Here we are, we made it to the last conference of the show, and that is Nintendo. Nintendo is usually my most anticipated conference of the show because I really love my Nintendo consoles, but this one was a little different. Let's talk about it. Nintendo. This show was very, very rough. Not because it didn't show anything of substance. They showed very substantial amounts of a thing, a very specific thing, but it was maybe a little too much. But we'll get to that. Before we get there, let's talk about the first game they showed at the beginning of the showcase, and that is called Daemon X Machina. Don't have a lot to say about this right now because it was just a trailer that showed some mechs fighting other mechs with some heavy metal rock music in the background. It was 100% all mood, but it was a mood that I am in for. I love me my giant robots fighting other giant robots. And it is coming sometime in 2019, like pretty much everything else announced at this E3. Moving on, we finally got a look at what Fire Emblem Switch is going to be, which was announced last year at E3, and it's called Fire Emblem Three Houses. Some of the things I noticed from this trailer were, one, when you have your overhead view of your map, you can actually see the entire character model of your units. It's not like a little sprite or anything. Two, it seems like some sort of relationship building thing is back in these games as well, because you had two characters kind of talking about what skills they should bolster. And three, maybe the thing that has me the most curious is when combat started, you had kind of like an army surrounding your main character, and it seemed like that army launched attacks along with you, as well as maybe made some sort of combo formation. It has me thinking about two things. One, they're adding some sort of visual element to make the battlefield seem more lively and giving the player some small amount of control over that. Or two, they're taking some cues from Fire Emblem Warriors and Dynasty Warriors, and that's maybe not exactly what I want in a Fire Emblem game. But I don't think it's that latter option all that much, to be honest. It did get pushed back. Last year it was announced for a vague 2018 release. Now it is a vague 2019 release, but I'm kind of okay with that because I still haven't gotten to the last two Fire Emblem games for 3DS. I even own them. They're both sitting on my desk right now. I'll probably pop one in later this year and play through those, and maybe the next one early next year before Fire Emblem Three Houses comes out. Anyway, before I move on to what was the big meaty part of the showcase, I'm going to talk about something that happened after the showcase at the Treehouse stream, and that was a bit of a large demo of Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee. It was a very substantial demo. We got some extended gameplay footage of walking around Viridian Forest, Pewter City, some capturing mechanics, even a bit of battles here and there. I was really curious on seeing more about the capturing because I know there are no battles in the capture mode. It obviously looks a lot like Pokemon Go. You even have to throw little raspberries to make the Pokemon easier to catch. But basing what I saw off that trailer, I think you don't have to be as precise and as careful to make sure the Pokeball hits right in the center of that little colored circle like you do in Pokemon Go. It seems like the Pokeball will always aim for the center, and you're only really moving the Joy-Con to determine the direction of your throw. So if a Pokemon is off to the right of the screen, you will throw right, but it will still aim towards the center, and you just gotta time it so when the circle is a lot smaller to make it easier to catch. But that's just me piecing things together from that demo. They didn't explicitly say anything besides being able to change the direction of your Pokeball throw by swinging the Joy-Con up and down or side to side. They also showed that experience will be split amongst your team when you catch a Pokemon, and how there's like a new item, little candies that you can feed to your Pokemon to boost their normal stats like HP, attack, special attack, etc. They even showed off transferring Pokemon Go to Pokemon Let's Go. It works pretty similarly to how the PAL Park worked in Heart Gold Soul Silver. I'm looking forward to that game. I know it's not exactly the Pokemon game I would want out of a Switch, but that is coming next year. This seems like a good mix of regular Pokemon mechanics and Pokemon Go to satisfy both players like me who just want to play a little bit of Pokemon and players who are new to the series because they picked up Pokemon Go. Now, let's talk about the big meaty thing in the main showcase, and that is Smash Brothers Ultimate. Nintendo ended their showcase with what felt like an eternity of Smash Brothers Ultimate. Now, before I go any further, I'm gonna tell you right now, I like Smash Brothers. I want to play this new Smash Brothers game, but it felt like they could have done this a better way. Smash Brothers Ultimate includes every single character that has ever been in Smash Brothers in one game. I like that idea a whole lot. It actually kind of feels like one last hurrah for Sakurai, because you know that he's always said how these games kill him and he's not gonna make any more, but maybe this one is the actual last one, especially because they mentioned there probably won't be that many new characters. Just putting everyone in one game and adding maybe one or two new folks seems like a good way to end an era. The problem is that they spent the entire rest of the conference talking about that one Smash game, about every little minute detail. And I know that is super important to the Smash community, I am not denying that, but I felt that that could have probably been done at the Treehouse stream, or maybe even in a series of small video features that they dish out, you know, day by day, week by week, leading up to the release of Smash Brothers in December. Oh yeah, by the way, the release date is December 7th this year. It was really disappointing, honestly. Nintendo needs to show off a bit more of what they have in store. Last year they announced Metroid Prime 4, and I get it, that game might be a ways off, but you can't just come out, announce it with just a logo, and then not talk about it for a year. It really puts a bad taste in people's mouth. Also, that Yoshi game is coming out later this year.
They done delayed it.
I'm not really a big fan of Yoshi games either, but that game is right around the corner.
No, it isn't. Just announced right after this video got shot.
And then finally, that Nintendo Online Switch service. That comes out in September. That needs to be talked about because all we have is this one website with a bunch of specs on it. It's incredible how they're not diving deeper into these things, especially at E3. I know that they have their own directs that they could do later down the road, but E3 is like the main hub, where everyone's eyes are on you at once. This is the place for you to announce all these big things. And they just didn't do that. Anyway, that is Nintendo. We are done with all the main conferences. We will be back later this week with some loose ends, things that got announced in the periphery, and putting that all in one video and making that our cap off of the entire convention or show. That's it. Thanks for watching, folks, and I'll see you guys soon. Bye.